Tell me something, girl. Are you happy?
Eita, já começou a gravação e eu nem vi, gente. Eita!
Sorry, I'm so sorry. I'm making my bed here. Tô arrumando a minha cama aqui. Porque depois que eu me tornei mãe, time management, gerenciamento de tempo, virou tudo na minha vida. Então aqui a gente arruma a casa, a gente ensina inglês, tudo ao mesmo tempo. E aí todo mundo fica feliz.
Hello and welcome to English in Brazil. This is another video that's almost 100% in English. So welcome to this new series on my channel. In this series, I'm gonna be doing something in English and then I'll be teaching you vocabulary related to this specific context. So in the first video of this series, I did my nails with you guys. So I taught you lots of vocabulary related to manicure and pedicure. And today I'm gonna be cleaning and organizing my house while I teach you new verbs and new expressions and new words.
Então, o objetivo dessa minha nova série é te ensinar vocabulário que a gente quase nunca aprende, né? Que quase nunca ninguém ensina, que são essas coisinhas do dia a dia. Então, espero que vocês gostem da ideia. E claro que tem legendas em português ou em inglês. Basta clicar nesses símbolos aqui, dependendo se você tá acessando o vídeo pelo computador ou pelo celular. Então, vou continuar minha organização aqui e vocês aí, ó, papel e caneta pra anotar as expressões novas.
I usually start with my bed. Room. I make my bed first and then I fluff my pillows like this. And I like to arrange all my pillows like this. But look at this! I have a pile of clothes to fold and this is something I hate doing. Folding all these clothes, oh my god, I don't like doing it. Actually, it's not that I hate folding my clothes, but sometimes I feel this task never ends. Every time I look around, there's another piece of clothing to be folded. Anyways, so now I'm folding my clothes and I'm smoothing them out with my hands so they become less wrinkled, okay? To fold your clothes, okay? This is an interesting expression. This is a hanger, right? And I'm putting this shirt on the hanger and then I'll hang it up, right? And this is my drawer, a drawer. And I'm gonna put away some clothes here. And I like rolling them because they get less wrinkled, right? So I always try to keep things organized like this, but I usually fail miserably, okay? So to put away is another very useful phrasal verb for you to talk about organizing things, okay? To put away. This is an iron, this device that I hate. I'm sorry, I hate ironing my clothes. But pay attention to the pronunciation. You say iron, iron, okay? To iron the clothes. And here, more things to put away, I told you. So let me put away this tiny shoe here. And now this is a broom. And I'm gonna pick up this rug here and start sweeping the floor. To sweep the floor. This is what I'm doing now. I'm sweeping the floor. And this is a dustpan. A dustpan. And now I'm sweeping the dust into the dustpan so I can throw it away. To throw away. To put it in the trash bin. Okay? So when you wanna get rid of something, you throw it away. Next step, the bathroom. So now I have to clean up the toilet. So first I will flush the toilet. To flush the toilet, this is what I'm doing now. And then I'll put in a toilet bowl cleaner and scrub it using the toilet brush. Mm-hmm. So it will be super, super clean. Now it's time to clean up the sink. Yeah, so this is the sink, right? So I grab a cloth, I wet this cloth, and I wring it out before I use the all-purpose cleaner. So to wring is another interesting verb for you to use in this context, to wring. And now the living room. Yeah, the living room. And I have this cup here so I can water this plant. To water the plants. This is also something that we have to do every day, at least 3 times a week, right? Otherwise, our plants will die and we don't want that. No, we don't. And the next verb I want to teach you is to dust. To dust. And this means to remove all the dust with a cloth or a duster. And I'm using a cloth here, a clean cloth, with furniture polisher. Furniture polisher. It smells really good. And then the kitchen. And here's the phrasal verb put away again. I'm putting away the plasticware. I'm taking all the things from the drying rack and putting them away. I'm putting them away. I'm putting them in the drawer. This is a sponge. And now I'm putting the soap on the sponge. I'm washing a glass right now. But if I wanted to say that I'm washing all of the things, I would say that I was washing the dishes or doing the dishes, okay? So you can say, okay, I'm washing a glass because this is something that's very specific. But when I talk about the whole process, when you're washing everything, you can say, I'm washing the dishes or doing the dishes. And I don't have a dishwasher, so after I do the dishes, I put them in the drying rack and let them air dry. I rarely use a cloth to dry my dishes. But let me know in the comment section if you have a dishwasher and if you usually use a cloth to dry your dishes or if you just let them air dry. This is a squeegee. Yeah, a squeegee. And I love my squeegee because when I use it, it means that I've finished everything. So you use a squeegee to remove the water on a flat surface like this, right? So we squeegee. And here's something I actually like to do, which is clean my stove. It is pretty dirty, as you can see, so I really need to clean this up. So I usually use a Brillo pad with this stove cleaner to clean it up, right? And then I clean it gently because I don't want to scratch the surface. Okay, I finished and oh my god, it's so shiny! It's blinding me! I need to put on my sunglasses. Aha! Now it's perfect. And one of the last steps in any cleaning process is the floor. So again, I take a cloth, I dip the cloth in water. I'm using a bucket here. This is a bucket. And then I wring this cloth and use a squeegee, a floor squeegee or a mop to clean the floor. Now my house is clean and organized, but I still have lots of clothes to wash. So this is my washing machine and I'm putting detergent in the machine and also fabric softener so my clothes will stay soft and smell good. So I'm doing the laundry. That's the expression we use to say that we're washing our clothes, right? So to do the laundry. And I don't have a dryer either, so I usually just hang up my clothes and let them air dry. And now I am taking them off the clothes rack. This is a clothes rack. And you know what I'll have to do next? I will have to start folding my clothes again and smoothing them out with my hands and then putting them away. And this is a never-ending process.
I told you time management was everything. As soon as I finished cleaning the kitchen, the baby woke up. Então assim que eu terminei de limpar a cozinha, o bebê acordou. Se gostou dessa série, deixa aqui nos comentários uma sugestão de outros assuntos que você gostaria de ver. De repente falar sobre carros, falar sobre comida, falar sobre bebê com sono. Não sei, deixa aqui nos comentários. Tô até sweating, tô com calor, suando, porque esse vídeo demandou um pouco de energia e agora eu vou finalmente take a rest, vou descansar porque tá tudo organizado e